Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and in this video, I'm here to talk about my favorite character from Mass Effect 2. So, in these series of videos where I talk about my favorite characters from video games, I've had this kind of rule for myself that if I talk about a male character from one video, in the next video it will be a female character, and then the video after that will be a male character, and the switch will happen, so on and so forth. I'm going to break that rule in this video. And that's not because I'm picking yet another female character just because my favorite character from Mass Effect 3 was a female character in the last video. My favorite character in Mass Effect 2 is not a female character, so I'm not breaking the rule in that sense of the manner. But my favorite character from Mass Effect 2 is not a male character either. My favorite character from Mass Effect 2 has no gender. It's a genderless character. So that's why I'm kind of breaking the rule here. It's kind of hard to have a male or female character when the character itself has no gender. Not technically. It does have a male voice, but it's hard to say that it's a male or female in that manner. And there's a similar character like that in Mass Effect 3 who doesn't really yet exist as a character in Mass Effect 2. So judging by those two hints there, everybody who knows Mass Effect Universe should probably already know who my favorite character is by this point. It's very easy to guess. Every other character does have a gender in the universe. So yeah, drum roll, and you guessed it, Legion, the Geth character. So it's an AI robotic character, so obviously it doesn't have a gender, even though its voice is like a male computer voice. Whatever, but it's also a collective, so it's not, Legion isn't one single person, it's a collective of Geth unified, so it's like multiple, it's an AI character, so the whole concept of this character is just mind-blowingly unique and amazing. And it's hard to say though that this is like, the reason why I picked this as my favorite character is really hard to justify in this game. And that's because Mass Effect 2 is such a character-driven game. It has a cast of characters that is so wide. It's a lot of characters. And all of those characters, almost all of them, have such an amazing role in the entire story of the game. So it's really hard to pick out which character as the most unique, the most important, or the favorite, because they're all pretty damn awesome. Except maybe there's one character that I don't like that much in the game, but people are not, there's going to be a lot of Mass Effect fans who are going to disagree with me on that, but I'm going to talk about that later in this video. But yeah, my point is, Mass Effect 2 is an amazing game when you consider its cast of characters. If I was to compare Mass Effect 2 to many other games, just the story and its the strength of its cast of characters, I feel like Mass Effect 2 just comes out on top almost every single time. To me, I can't think of a game, and I hate comparing and contrasting games, but this is like one area where I like to do this thought experiment, like, does Mass Effect 2, is it the best game in terms of its cast of characters compared to any other game out there? And right now, maybe I need to, play more, I haven't played enough games or whatever, but I feel like Mass Effect 2 is. That's saying a lot. And that's because many other games, for example, my favorite game franchise by far is Metal Gear Solid. But Metal Gear Solid is a very plot-driven series. It has a lot of throwaway characters for that regards, or characters who are just fan service characters. So if you could just consider the cast of characters, definitely not as strong as Mass Effect 2. And when you compare Mass Effect 2 to the other Mass Effect games, not the case either. Because Mass Effect 2 has a much more characters. It has ridiculous amount of characters. And then there's the other character-driven games. I don't know why I'm thinking of Disgaea for some reason, but Disgaea, for example, and Valkyria Chronicles, or any other character-driven games, their characters are really great, but what's the problem with those stories is that only like the story or the game focuses on very few amount of characters, the main characters or the few side characters, and the rest of the characters are just throwaways or not important to the game at all. Which is not the case for Mass Effect 2. Mass Effect 2 has an incredible roster of characters. So many of them. It's hard to choose who to play as when you're starting as a mission for me. When not considering gameplay, but when you're just considering story and the dialogue you want to be engaged in. So, in that regard, it's a pretty damn amazing game. And so, I can't really explain why, in particular, why Legion is the character that I'm most drawn to, but that just happens to be the case. And it's really ironic because Normandy is not my favorite character in Mass Effect 3. So it's not just because Legion is an AI robotic character that I'm drawn to it. Because Normandy becomes like a humanoid character. She becomes an actual character. This is where gender becomes really confusing to talk about when you're talking about either Normandy or Legion. Because it's AI, it doesn't really have a gender per se. But Normandy is an interesting character, but it's like, you know, it's kind of expected the way she talks, the way she thinks, the way she learns human concepts. Legion has its own philosophy. It's just like the Geth has a collective intelligence and knowledge base that it has, and Legion is just a physical manifestation of that. Which is so mind-blowingly, like, to me, amazing and unique to consider. But then, in Mass Effect 2, you have crazy unique characters like Jack, Morden. Oh, Morden is an amazing character. Jacob started out as kind of, typical run-of-the-mill kind of character, but he has an amazing backstory to him that I thought was pretty unique. Tali is mysterious and enigmatic as ever. And then there's the DLC characters like Kasumi, who is actually much more enigmatic than Tali. Garrus is still there. Grunt. The introduction of Grunt is like such an amazing character. Justicar Samara. Really, the cast of characters in Mass Effect 2 is fantastic. That's really all I can say. It's an amazing game considering its cast of characters. It's to me, when you consider the overall plot and the overall, I guess, story impact of the of Mass Effect 2 to the entire franchise, it's kind of weak when you consider that. Like, most of the plot goes. Mass Effect 3 is responsible for most of the franchise's plot. The overall arching story of the Reapers are coming to destroy the Earth. Mass Effect 3 is the most responsible for that. And gameplay-wise, Mass Effect 1 is the most complex and deep, whereas Mass Effect 2 is kind of, like, the combat mechanics aren't as refined as Mass Effect 3, so it's kind of, you know, the gameplay is not quite up to the par of Mass Effect 3, and it's not quite as complex as Mass Effect 1, and the story is kind of just recruit these characters and have them join and have this boss fight against this crazy skull-looking thing. When you consider just the overall picture, Mass Effect 2 is really not that strong, but then its characters are what makes this game shine. And that's why, like, even picking Legion, who in any other game would be an incredible character, would be a character that just really stands out, doesn't really stand out that much in Mass Effect 2 because there's so many other amazing characters in this game. So that's really my favorite thing about Mass Effect 2. The only character that I really did not like in Mass Effect 2, and this is debatable to many of the fans, is Miranda. Miranda. I can't even pronounce her name correctly, sorry. But Miranda is definitely, like, Miranda Lawson is not a character that I grew too fond of. Because I think it makes sense when you consider the story. She is genetically engineered to be this character. And so she's flat, she's combat-oriented, and she has, like, a black-and-white view of things. It makes sense because, in the story-wise, that's how she was designed, genetically engineered to be. But, to me, that makes her boring. And she's, again, I hate characters that are just kind of there for sex appeal. And Miranda is, like, the character most guilty of that in the entire franchise. just a sex appeal character, which is not true necessarily, but compared to any of the characters, the other characters have more stake in the universe, except maybe Jaid, who is a DLC character. He's kind of, I guess he's the throwaway character, if you will, but he's not, you know, because he's a side DLC character, I don't really consider him that much. But Miranda is like the main, one of the main characters, especially in Mass Effect 2. For a character that has such a humongous amount of screen time in the game, you know, it's a character that I found it to be the flattest character. I haven't even come to asking the question, who's the most important character in Mass Effect 2? And honestly, in this game, I feel like it's kind of an irrelevant question, because I don't even know how to answer that, don't even know the answer, and don't care to answer that question. All I know is Mass Effect 2 characters are some of the most unique characters in the game universe, and it's amazing that so many of them are gathered together in one single game. That's amazing. And out of those characters, all those characters, I had to pick Legion. So that makes me very interested in learning about your guys' thoughts. Who are your favorite characters in Mass Effect 2? Who is your favorite character? And also, who is your least favorite? I know that's hard to pick, too, because characters are so amazing. Miranda was easy to pick for me, but after that, if I had to answer the question of who is my least favorite character in Mass Effect 2, I don't know. That's a tough one.